Oh, come on, load this fucking site. Pennywisewaitmanagement.com. Oh, come on, shit. Okay, guys, so we are going to talk about Pennywise investment once again, maybe for the last time, I don't know. But for the past 2 days, Pennywise management or investment management site has not been loading, okay? It has not been going through. Now people are reaching out to me in masses that Pennywise is a scam and this and that. Now, I said it right from time that Pennywise investment is not going to stand the test of time. But there are so many criticism right there, talking and trash talking and all of that, calling me names, curses and all of that. It's just so nasty. It's a very nasty experience when people come out and say things without this clear judgment. Now, one thing you know to know about us is this is Slow Reviews, of course. Let me show you my channel. I make business and investment reviews, so I'll let you know if it is legitimate or not. We are going to tell you beforehand before the danger comes. So if you are following our channel, do well to subscribe, so whenever we post a new video, you'll be notified and you can stay away from all these bad investments. A couple of months ago, Pennywise Investments, I created a video on it. As a matter of fact, my video is number one video on Pennywise Investments. Okay, you can see 2 months ago, I reviewed Pennywise Investments, and so many people came on me. It was hell, okay? It was hell. People came and started saying all sort of things underneath my video. Let me check some of the comments. You can see the video has a lot of dislike, okay? Now, 140 like, 55 dislike. So many people just dislike it for no reason. Now, people will always remain people for the fact that they are making money from it and they are getting referral commission. They will go to any length to say a business is legitimate. Now, if anybody is trying to bring you into a business, is trying to tell you how good a business is, now you need to look at it in two perspectives. First one is, what are you going to gain? Okay, now what you're going to gain is the card or is the bait, like a bait. Okay, now if you know of a fishing line, it has a bait on the water that shows the movement of the hook. Now that is the bait that they want to fish you with. Now, that is the bait. Okay, if you check what the person is introducing to you and say, okay, what am I going to gain from it? That is the bait. Now, next is, what is the person going to gain? That is the catch. Yeah, that is the catch. Now, you feed the hook line with a worm or something. Then you throw it to the river. Then if the fish just take it, that okay, I like this offer, just swallow it, start running away. Then oops, you draw it back. And you get the fish. So the fish is the catch. Now, when someone introduces you to a business that I want you to do this business, it's very profitable and all of that, don't look at it as, okay, what am I going to gain alone? Look at it in the sense that, what is the person going to gain? Then look at it in the other critic sense, that is this business really worth it? Is it really sustainable? Because I don't think it's fun for us to just keep losing money to all these cheap scams. Now, if you find it fun and you really like the idea, then you can actually keep up doing those businesses. So I created this video and so many people came. So I'll just try to go through some of the comments. I deleted so many of them, but I still left some. You can look at this guy right here, Ojo Oluwafemi. 1 month ago, he said, you are not a good reviewer. Very poor review indeed. You don't know how it works. All you need to tell people is that to be mindful of Bitcoin volatility. I discredit your reviews. It's lacking in depth and substance. Please learn about the operation of Bitcoin and come back with substance. Thanks. Now, these kind of people that they go about and say this business is good and all of that. Now, most of them, they are not part of the founding members of that business. That is the painful part. They are not part of it, but they go around dropping comments because they are earning from it immediately. Most Nigerians, they drop a penny into a business and they get paid once. They'll try to gather more money. They can take loan and put it back into the business, that the business is legitimate, that they want to make more profit. And that is the wrong way to go about it. That is very wrong, because these guys, they have a catch, okay? But they are feeding you with debate. They are feeding you with debate. So whenever it gets to time whereby they have huge return, they are going to run away with your money. That is the end. That is how it's going to end. Okay, now if these people like this, now if you try to contact them, they won't say anything at this point in time when it's crashed. Okay, they won't say anything. And now let's check another comment. Let's check another comment. It's funny enough how people go around that. Now there are these gullible people, because of the, what's it called, the referral commission they are going to get, they move around saying it is legitimate and all of that crap to get more people into it, for just there for their selfishness. Now when we review business opportunity here, we don't tell you to join under any link or whatsoever. We don't have anything to gain. Okay, it's not as if we are dropping you a link that when you sign up under us, we are going to make some affiliate commission or all those crap. Okay, we just give our own generic review. Many a times people reach out to me to pay, that they want to pay for me to review their site. Although the payment is good, everybody wants money. But once I check the site and I can see that it's crappy, I'll tell the person, your business is shitty, I can't review it for any amount. Okay, I can't give you a positive review, I'm going to give you a negative review, you don't have to pay me for it. So stuff like that, that is how we operate here. So we tell you the truth, the facts, and nothing less. So this guy right here said, Olaya, have been with Pennywise since January 26th, and I will say I've never been disappointed. Even during the arrival of the pandemic, they see, you know, those kind of comments. Some of them, because they are getting referral commission and all of that, now they keep on supporting it. If you try to reach out to them now, if they have anything to say about it, they're going to tell you that investment is risk and you should invest with your spare money. It is always shitty to invest into something that you know that is going to crash for sure. So that is not wise investment. I saw the work review, but still invested. I've earned close to 400 now. This guy John, I'm very sure he's not going to come out by this time again. It's not going to come out. They will all run away when it happens. Now, most of the painful part is, most of these guys dropping comments, they are all orchestrated by the company. Once they launch the company, immediately they launch the company, they have so many accounts, okay? Once they see that they start having reviews about it, they go online and search for their names. If they see it on any website that doesn't speak well of their business, they drop a lot of negative comments there. If they see it on YouTube, they drop a lot of negative comments there. That is how they do around now. Let's see it this way, that you are a scammer. Or sorry, let's say I am a scammer or you are a scammer. Okay? Now, and if you have a business and your mindset is to dupe people, that is your work. That is how you make your living. That is how you earn. And you create a business, you create a strategy, a kind of trap for people to put in their money. And your main aim is to run away with the money at the long run. And you have someone telling the world that the business, your business is not good. That person is trying to destroy the ambition you have to scam. Are you going to take it lightly? No. It is normal for them to go out and criticize those kind of content. But some people that are not used to all this internet stuff and the like, they just go about and say there are so many people saying positive things about it on the internet. So they just go ahead and put their money. Okay? So it is very, very wrong. And there are so many comments like that. So many comments. This one says, "Okay, stop guessing. No, if you don't know, please ask. Pennywise doesn't collect your money. They don't have access to it." Okay, that's funny. Well, I have seen people close to me who have earned. Now, people like this, they are always many. They always see people who are close to them that are earning, but they never earn. Too many people even say that Pennywise has been around for 10 years or 3 years or thereabouts. If you ask them to show their payment proof for the 3 years they've been with Pennywise, they will just disappear to they won't say any other thing. This Choku Yere thereabout said, "I've earned 400 so far, about 3 weeks. I see observing and things like that." Okay. So in I don't want to go through all the comment. Okay. Can this is one. "Stop saying what you cannot prove. This dude is a liar. Pennywise is real as the air you breathe. I rest my case." Okay, so many any comments praising Pennywise, you see that it has a lot of thumbs up and all of that. Now, let me see how they arranged it. Okay, right from the first one. "But lately, for the past 2 days or thereabout, people start coming to my channel and they are saying that it is scam. They lose so much amounts of money that Pennywise is no longer reachable and stuff like that." Now, you guys should have expected it right from time. Okay, you should have expected it. Once you invest with people that are faceless, that don't have identity, it is very bad. Look at this mad Benedicta. She was saying all sorts of things then. You are hoping people lose their money, but many people have gotten their capital back. However, I don't stand for wrong investment, but your review is too poor. Your grammar and words are not even friends. Now, it's not about the fluency of the grammar, okay? Nobody's gonna eat the grammar, young woman. We just want to tell people good and bad investments so that they need to stay away from it and don't get scammed. Now, with all your good grammars, you couldn't stop the Pennywise from crashing anyway. So, it's not about the grammar. Now, let's head into the few points I have here in the Word document for us. Where is Pennywise investments? Now, they disappeared into thin air, okay? There's nothing you can do about it because right from time, you don't know who is behind it. They don't have a contact details. But blindly, some people still went to invest with them. Now, they copied the site from Australia. Now, the Australia site made a disclaimer that they don't have any affiliation with the Pennywise that is running, okay? As a result of that disclaimer, it affected them. And they are trying to hide now. They don't have a face. Someone is saying they are from UK and all of that. But even if you are from UK, you'll be registered. They are not registered. They have nothing in the UK. So, there's no way you can find it. Now, who is behind it? Right from time I say it. Do not invest your money with faceless people. It is very, very wrong. Okay? Now, if money is very easy to come by for you, then you can actually throw it around. But for majority of people on God's earth, money is not easy to come by. So do not invest your money with faceless people. Any kind of, only if it is decentralized, like all these smart contracts and wherever, whereby there is no central admin. Your money is not going to any central admin. Now, if your money is going to a central admin and they are claiming to make investments with it, be it Bitcoin or Forex, I will advise you to stay away from such fucking business, okay? There's no such thing as investing into Bitcoin and Forex that will give you a high return in a short period of time. It doesn't work that way, okay? It doesn't work that way. So you guys need to stay away from bad investment like that. Then how can we contact them? Of course, they don't have contact details. Now you should be very skeptical about stuff when people come out with business models or a kind of investment site and you don't have their contact details. Who on God else does that? You want me to invest my money with you, to entrust my money into your hands, and you can't show your face, you can't make a video explaining how your business works, and you can't also drop a phone number where we can reach you, okay? You're 100% incognito. You hid everything about you, concealed your identity, and you want me to trust you. Now it's very, very wrong. Say it pays, doesn't matter. Now scam has moved from paying, or scam that's moved from taking your money immediately to join to the point whereby they pay for almost 6 months before they run away. Now, any site that is paying for 6 months would have gained a lot of traction, a lot of attention, and a lot of customers. That is the point where it gets juicy, okay? Then you run away with the money. That is how it works. Now, this is serving as a kind of a lesson to some of us, or to those of us that participated, and to some of us that stayed away from it. This is like a lesson for everybody. So whenever such shitty investment comes out again, and someone bring it right to you to invest into it just to get affiliate commission, stay away from it. Just tell the person you are not interested in stuff like that. Stuff that they don't have identity, and stuff that you are no longer interested in wasting your money throwing it around. I made videos about Wazobia investment also. So many kind of critics and all of those trash talks in the comment section. Now, Wazobia has crashed. All those guys say it is legitimate. Where are they? They won't say anything again. Everybody will just move on. So stop investing into bad investments. Now, once again, it is slow reviews, of course. So we make business and investment reviews. We let you know if it is legitimate or not. So if you want to be part of this great community, you do it to subscribe, okay? So that whenever we create new content, you'll be notified immediately and you can know what is going on. You stay updated. You know of good investments and bad ones. Thank you, guys, and have a lovely weekend.